Okay, so section 10.1, look over to the sideboard here. Student will be able to simplify radical expressions. Simplify radical expressions, okay? So simplify means we're going to be doing some mathematical operations to make it simpler, okay? Radicals, what's a radical? The square root, okay? The radical is our square root symbol. Radical is our square root symbol. Okay, an expression just means that it's written there and there's no equal sign. That's the only difference between an expression and an equation, is that an equation has an equal sign, an expression does not. So our warm-up problems from earlier, these were expressions because there was no equal sign. Okay, so here when we're simplifying radicals, we have this product property for radicals that we need to talk about. So we're going to say for any numbers a and b, any two numbers a and b, the radical of whatever a times b is, if they're both under the same radical, is really just equal to the radical a times the radical b. And if we write it next to each other, that just means they're being multiplied. If we write it next to each other, that just means they're being multiplied, just like if we write two variables next to each other, stuff like that. We're saying that this is the same though, okay? So when they're both under the square root, it's really the same thing as if you separate them and have them in two different square roots versus if they're in the same. It's really the same thing. Like square root of the square root? That would be like a fourth root.
That's a thing.
Yeah, like the fourth root of 16 is 2.
It like zero is smart math.
Or the cube root of 8
so
is
it's
3,
like,
or 2, excuse me.
Let's
it's
not
it's like whatever times itself
yeah.
4 times,
okay.
Get there.
Let's not go there right now.
That's okay. So when we have a perfect square.
Guys, stop.
When we have a perfect square, we take the square root, and the answer was what kind of number?
Positive.
Okay, that's true.
Prime.
Not necessarily, because the square root of
2 is 1.
Okay, no. The square root of 36 is 6, and 6 was a prime. Okay? We get a whole number. We don't get a decimal. So whenever we take a perfect square, the square root of a perfect square, we got a whole number, didn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of nice and convenient for us. Okay? For example, the square root of 100 is what?
10.
So because 100 is a perfect square, take the square root, we got a whole number. We didn't get a decimal. Now, with the square root of 100, according to this product property, we can say that the square root of 100 is really the same thing as the square root of 25 times what number?
4.
And there's 4 quarters in the dollar. Okay, 4 quarters would make 100 cents.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay. Change, okay. So we're saying that these are the same things. Because if you multiply 25 times 4, what do you get?
100.
So we're saying these two are equivalent. Because just like last chapter, when we did the quadratic formula, we did all of our stuff underneath that radical, didn't we? We still did our addition, subtraction underneath the radical. You guys remember that?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're saying these are the same things. So according to our product property here, according to our product property up here, we can take this, and we can now make it the square root of 25 times the square root of 4. According to our product property, we're saying, hey, if these two multiply together, we can split them into two different radicals.
5 times 2.
And that would end up being, the square root of 5 ends up being 5, and the square root of 4 ends up being 2. And what is 5 times 2? 10. Did we get the same thing?
Yeah.
So does that mean that mathematically this is okay to do? Now this was more work, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it's more work this time, but it's going to help us out other times that we're going to learn about. Okay, and it's easiest to show you guys an example where even though it goes longer, that we see it ends up being the same. And we see, oh yeah, okay, I guess that's okay. We got the same thing. We don't have to panic and say, can we do this? Well, we got the same answer. And all of our math, we said, okay, well, 25 times 4 is 100, okay, and we can multiply it with the square root, and we can split that up because we just learned that, and square root of 25 is 5, square root of 4 is 2, and we know that 5 times 2 is 10. Okay, yeah, all that math makes sense. taking it through just one step at a time there can help us out. Okay, great question. Graydon asked, hey, why would they not be a positive, a negative 5, and a positive negative 2, okay? So here's the thing with that. The only time we had the positive negative show up was when we took the square root of both sides of an equation. So when we started out and we had x squared was equal to 9, we took the square root of both sides. And when you take the square root yourself, you do that operation, it's like, oh, I'm going to add 4 to both sides. I'm going to subtract this to both sides. Multiply, blah, 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 blah. If you square root both sides, then you have the positive negative action going on. Okay? But if the square root's already given to you, like we're just told, oh, I don't know, the square root of 100 is equal to x, you don't have to worry about positive and negative because the square root's already there. We're already told it's just the positive one.
And square roots are negative, never negative, so it's just positive.
What did you say, Ben?
Square roots are never negative, right?
Well, underneath the square root can't be negative, otherwise it's imaginary.
Yeah. So it's like it already knows that it.
The equation already knows it's positive, actually, because if it's not written there, if we just have a number, like if we just write 10 here, we assume that's a positive 10, correct? We don't have to write a plus symbol. We just know it's positive. Just like here with the square root, if it's already written, given to us, we assume it's positive. So the only time we have positive and negative is when we actually take the square root ourselves. When we perform that operation ourselves, we have that symbol. But otherwise, if it's given to us, we just say, oh, we just have the positive end. We just have whatever's given to us. Does that make more sense, Graydon? Okay, that was a good question. Right. Just focus back up here, okay? Where we had square root of 100 end up going through all these different steps to get to the 10. Now, if it wasn't a perfect square, we said if it was, had a whole number. If it wasn't a perfect square, what kind of answers were we finding? Okay, exact and approximate, which was the decimals, right? It's the decimals. Okay, those were our approximate ones. So we found exact and approximate answers. Now, what we're going to learn here is that we can sometimes use the product property, that's this up here that we just learned, to simplify our exact answers. So we can make our exact answers more simplified. For example, I do want you guys to write this in this for example spot. Square root of 8. Is 8 a perfect square? No. But with our product property, what two numbers can multiply to equal 8? 4 and 2. So we can say this is the same thing as the square root of 4 times 2, correct? Can we say that 4 times 2 is 8? Yeah, so we can say the square root of 4 times 2 is the same thing as the square root of 8. Notice they're both underneath the radical still. It's important. And then what can we do with the square root of 4 over times 2? Separate them into two different square roots. Square root of 4 times square root of 2. 2 is not a perfect square, is it? But what is? 4. So what can this 4 become? A 2, is it underneath the radical anymore?
No.
No, we did the operation. Very good. So we have 2, and then what operation was this square root of 4 doing with the square root of 2? Were they adding?
Multiplying.
So this 2 is going to multiply with our square root of 2. And we'll have 2 times the square root of 2 as our answer. Now, did we end up getting a perfect square still? Like, did we end up getting it down just a whole number? No. But we have a much smaller square root than before. Instead of having 8 underneath the square root, we now have square root of 2.
Yeah, we can't take the square root of 2 times the 2. We're going to calculate.
Yeah.
Okay, can you put this in your calculator and figure out what it'd be approximately? Yeah, you can still take this and figure out the approximate, but right now, we're just working on simplifying our exact answers. We're just working on simplifying our exact answers. And so this is still exact, because did we round it all? No, we never had a round once. But this is a more simplified version of our exact answer because this radicand, remember the radicand, that's the vocab term underneath the radical, got smaller. Instead of 8, it's 2 now. We like that. We like when the radicand gets smaller. We're going to practice this.
What? No way.
Yes. We're going to learn a skill and practice it. What? No, we don't do that during math ever. Yeah, we do it all the time, okay? So right beneath this, square root of 90. Square root of 90. Actually, let me first make an adjustment to this. Okay. Because I want to say, for this, we probably need, square root of 90. What two things can multiply to be the square root of 90?
9 and 10.
Okay, I heard 9 and 10, I heard 3 and 30. Okay, let's think about 3 and 30 for a second here. Don't have to write this down real quick. Square root of 3 and square root of 30. Is it okay for us to write it like that?
Yeah.
Are you guys okay with me skipping the step of going from?
Oh, no, don't do that.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, actually.
Okay, because we could skip straight from here down to this line if you wanted, instead of taking this detour through here, okay? Either way you guys are more comfortable with, okay? Now, is 3 a perfect square? Is 30 a perfect square?
No.
So would we be able to really do much more with that?
No.
So what's going to help us is looking for perfect squares, like 9 and 10. Why would 9 and 10 help us?
Because 9 is, and 10 is.
9 is a perfect square, but 10
is
not a perfect square. So if we say it's a square root of 9 times a square root of 10 instead of 3 and 30, now we have a perfect square. And what is the square root of 9?
3.
Do we know the square root of 10? Are there any more perfect squares inside of it?
No.
Okay, because what are the factors of 10?
5 and 2.
Are either of those perfect squares?
No, 10 and 1.
Okay, 10 and 1. And 1's a perfect square, but would that help it get any smaller?
No.
Okay, so we have 3 square root of 10 as our answer.
Just wait.
Okay, could we split 10 again? Okay, into what? If there was a perfect square, then yes.
Sure.
We'll talk about that on some of these. We'll talk about that on these, okay? That'll come up.
Okay.
So, little sidebar, which is why I moved this over, is it's going to be good for us to know some of our perfect squares, right? Look at all them chickens, okay? So, we're going to quickly review our first 10 perfect squares off to the side, which is why I wrote this here. I have it on my notes. Please write it on your notes off to the side of this little margin. Okay? 1 squared is. 2 squared is. 3 squared is. 9. 4 squared is. 16. Okay? I'll slow down. 5 squared is 25. Thank you, Peyton. 6 squared is 36, 7 squared is 49, 8 squared is 64, 9 squared is 81, and then 10 squared is 100. We're going to stop there for now. Okay, we could keep going, blah, 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 blah. We're going to stop with those first 10 just as a reminder. Okay, so what we want to look for as we go through this is we want to see if any of these perfect squares, any of these perfect squares on the right, are a factor of this number underneath the radical. So here, 9 is a factor of 90. So we're like, oh, that's a winner. We have a perfect square. Exactly right. Winner, winner, look at all the chicken dinners. Okay? Square root of 27. Okay? We look over at our square roots, at our perfect squares. Is it reasonable for 36 to be a factor?
No.
Why not?
Bigger.
It's bigger, okay? So what's the first number that would be reasonable to say? 25, the first one beneath it. But is 25 a factor?
No.
Is 16 a factor? No. What is?
3, 9.
So we have the square root of 9 times the square root of 3. Now what I'm going to keep doing...
That's what you said.
Okay? Now, heads up, we can write multiplication in either order, correct? We can do 3 times 9 or 9 times 3. I'm going to keep writing a perfect square first. Okay, I suggest writing the perfect square at 9 before the other factor, okay? Suggest writing the perfect square first.
Holy shoot, I
okay. Square root of 9 is 3. That's why we did this. Square root of 3, can we simplify that at all? No. And that's our answer. Because can we multiply 3 times the square root of 3 anymore?
No.
No. radical and what is not. Okay. Questions on the second one. On this third one, square root of 10. Okay, what are we thinking? 5 and 2. Okay, are 5 and 2 perfect squares? No. Okay, they're what? Okay, 1 is. So we could do like square root of 10, square root of 1, okay? And the square root of 1 is just 1. So would that help us at all?
No.
No, because we just be left with the square root of 10, right?
Yeah.
So the answer just is the square root of 10. It's a trick question.
Oh, really?
Yes. It's a trick question.
So you just circle it
like tricks. Yep. Because that's as reduced as it can get. There's no perfect squares that are factors that go into it, so to speak.
Cool.
Yes.
There has to be a perfect square for you to
work. There has to be a perfect square that the factors work for it to work, yes. Because here's the thing, here's why it has to be a perfect square. It's because we have to be able to take the square root of it and for this to work. So we can only take the square root of perfect squares and get a whole number. So we don't know the square root of 17 off the top of our head, but we know the square root of 16. We want those perfect squares. Fourth one here. Square root of 150. 150. Okay.
Seven.
So I heard 25, square root of 25 as a perfect square. How many times, how many quarters would it take to get to $1.50?
Six.
Think in terms of quarters. Okay. Every day only 25. Think in terms of quarters. Okay. Okay. So square root of 25 is, we heard, 5. Square root of 6. What are the factors of 6? Is 6 a perfect square, first of all? No? Okay. What are factors of 6?
2
and 3. And 6 and 1. Are any of those perfect squares besides that one that won't help us?
2.
Is 2 a perfect square? No, it's not. Okay. So we just end up leaving this as square root of 6 then. If there are no perfect squares that, quote unquote, go into it, are factors of it, and we leave it. And we already said, hey, square root of 1, that doesn't help us at all. That's just busyness. Yeah, that's just busy work up here doing the square root of 1. Why would we do that? That's just wasting our time.
If you would still write it instead of just circling the square root of 10, would it be wrong or right?
I mean, it's still writing. It's just kind of weird that you wrote it. It'd be like, weird flex, but okay. No. I'd probably actually even write that. I wrote that on a test last week. It wasn't weird. I wrote, well, yes, but actually no, on a test.
No, I'm curious.
Oh, my. It was in geometry, but, because it was dealing with the square root, actually, because this student wrote positive and negative for a number, because you had to square root both sides of an equation to get the answer, but it was with distance, and you can't have negative distance. So I'm like, well, yes, you do get a positive and negative answer, but you disregard the negative answer. Have negative distance. So I'm like, well, yes, but actually, no. Minus half. It's true. Okay. Okay. Square or 5. Square root of 200. Okay. Does 4 go into it?
Yes.
I think so. Let's try it.
Oh,
4 times 50. Okay. So if we do 4 times 50, we do 4 times 50 here. What is the square root of 4?
2.
2. Square root of 50, do we know that?
No.
No.
I think there is one, though, because 5 can go into it.
5 can go into it? Okay, 5 can go into 50? Okay. 5 and 10 could. Okay, are there any other factors of 50 that might be
25 and 2.
25 and 2. So could we keep going with this one?
Yeah.
And make it the square root of 25 and the square root of 2?
Wow.
Okay.
Wait, no.
Take a face forward. Thank you. Okay. Hey, does this make sense why we kept going here instead of stopping at square root of 50?
Sure.
Anyone have any questions on that real quick before we continue this?
Okay, one question.
Yes.
Why are the 25, so like square root and then 25 times 2 is square root, not square root 2 square root?
Why are these not under the same square root?
Yeah.
We could do that. That was like up here. That was like up here when we said here we could go square root of 9 times 10, but we just skipped that step. So that's the same thing. Does that answer your question? No. So 2, and then what's this 2 times the square root of 25 doing right now?
Multiplying.
So what would 2 and 5 do?
Ten.
Still be multiplying. Okay? common mistake for people, I want to highlight this, common mistake for people would say, oh, 2 and this ends up being 5, that's 7. What operation did you do there then? An add. But is there a plus symbol anywhere?
No.
No, we're multiplying. Okay, square root of 2, is that going to change?
No.
Square root of 2. So this ends up being what? 10 times the square root of 2. Now here we kind of had to reload and go again, didn't we? We found our first wave and then we said, oh, we got to keep going though with that second one.
Sweet.
Be careful to watch for that. Is 4 and 50, we're not the biggest, 4 isn't the biggest perfect square that goes into it. If we look over here, does 100 go into 200?
Yes.
Yes. Is 100 a bigger perfect square?
Yes.
Let's look at what happens when we choose a much bigger perfect square. That is still a factor. You don't have to write this one down if you don't want. Square root of 200, we can call that square root of 100 times what? Square root of 2. Make sure they're both underneath the square root, though, okay? Another big thing I see, okay, is we'll write square root of 100 times normal 2. No. They both have to be under the square root for this to work, okay? Square root of 100 is 10. Did we just get to the answer, like, a lot faster?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay? This is why you want to look for the biggest perfect square. So earlier on, was it this one? On number 2? I went from here, and I just kept asking, continuing on, didn't I? Because that's what we do. Is we say 200, okay, and you go to your biggest one, in this case it would be 196, and you keep looking and going closer, because if you find the biggest perfect square, you save yourself time and work.
196,
what?
Are you
going to
give us a perfect square chart?
No.
Ooh.
What were
we
asking, Justin?
196.
Well, that would be the highest right before this. You can try the next one tonight by yourself.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Hey, Justin. I know, Mr. Dawson.
I really hate when you do that. I'm so disrespectful.
What? Me?
I'm mad for you.
I'm not mad
at you. I know, but I'm mad for you because you're not mad.
Okay. That's right.
Weird flex, but okay. She's just using you for your planner, Grace.
I was in here.
Guys, shh, too loud, shh, guys, stop, thank you. If I say it's too loud, I don't want you guys to keep talking, make it a side comment, okay? Blake, do you have the notes on your desk or did I not have something there?
Yeah.
You okay? Perfect. But you do have a copy of your of the notes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's talk through this one, guys. Voices off, phones away, that kind of stuff. Thank you. Okay. So on number 6, we have this 3 out in front. Is that really going to change what we do much, though? No. We still want to look for a perfect square. So what's a perfect square that goes into 45? Okay. Square root of 9 is a perfect square, and the square root of 5. What is the square root of 9?
3.
3. So I have this 3 times 3. Are we going to add those?
No.
No, we're not going to make a plus sign appear out of thin air. That'd be silly. We have 9 times the square root of 5. Can we simplify the square root of 5 at all? No. Can we multiply 9 times the square root of 5 anymore?
No.
Because 1's underneath the radical and 1 is not, so they cannot multiply any closer together. We're done. Questions on that one? Okay. Yes, you guys can do the next one on your own. Okay. So you guys can practice. Yeah. Why we're practicing. Okay. As you're finished, as you finish up number 7, guys, boys, girls, as you finish number 7, please raise your hand, or as you have questions, please raise your hand. What operation are those two?
That's the only way I know to do it.
What operation are from our four? It's really funny doing. We don't let them interact any more than that. One is very important, but when I'm interacting, we just want to look at what's underneath the ear, and if we can simplify what's underneath there, we'll do the same thing we know in verse 6. Okay, 16 is less than that. I mean, it doesn't go into it. Does 9 go into it? Okay, what's next? But it's not because this is 4. That's a coincidence.
Oh, yeah. But the 4 goes into the 20.
Square root of 4, square root of 5, yes. No, because if we convert to on the table, for example, square root of 6, could we make that square root of 2 times square root of 3? Yeah, but is that simpler? No, it would be simpler for us to do a square root of 6. Does that make sense? Alright, voices off please and thank you.
Yeah.
Guys? Thank you. So 4 times the square root of 20. Do we do anything with this 4 right away? No, it stays out there. Square root of 20, what can we turn that into? Normal 4 and over 5? Square root of 4 and square root of 5. We have to make sure we have the square root on those, okay? I want you guys to be very, very descriptive as you tell me that, okay? Square root of 4, square root of 5. Why did we choose the square root of 4 instead of like square root of 2 and square root of 10? Because those aren't perfect squares, but is 4 a perfect square? Yes. And what is the square root of 4?
2.
So what are this 4 and 2 going to do? Multiply, because that's what 4 and square root of 4 are doing. Square root of 5, can we simplify that part anymore? No. So what is 4 times 2? 8. And so our final answer is 8 times the square root of 5. Okay? Jacob, please stop playing with that. Okay? I never thought I'd have to confiscate water in a high school classroom until I met you. Okay. Okay. Any questions on number 7? Okay, I want you guys to do number 8 and 9 on your own, please. I want you guys to work on 8 and 9 on your own. Okay, so you guys can practice.
The gag is it gets way more.
Hey, thank you. Whoever shushed, thank you. We need that. Okay, you don't even have your... Why are you raising your hand? You have them. Oh. Okay, my bad. Sorry. Come here real quick, Justin. So here, what is the square root of 4? So can you help me wrong? Yes. So you found two back marks, but the thing is, you need a perfect square. How does that enable us to take the square root and actually get that number smaller? Side conversations need to stop, okay? If you're done, I'm going to ask that you sit quietly. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay, hopefully that was a little bit of kind of a brain break there for you. Let's look right below. Sorry you feel that way. Is something better than nothing then?
Okay.
Is that going to just give you nothing?
No, I'm cool.
Okay. If you're cold, here's a pro tip, okay? Stand in the corner, they're 90 degrees. Are those like terms?
No.
No. Can we do anything?
No. No, you can probably.
Oh, we're going to add. No, let's let Grace finish. Go ahead. Okay, do you want to phone a friend?
Wait. You can separate the equations into
different. We can look to simplify them.
Yeah.
Like we did like last page, right? Okay, we can look to simplify these. Okay, square root of 90. What can that become?
3 and
30. Okay, 3 and 30. We said that before. Does 3 and 30, does that help us?
9 and 10.
9 and 10. 9 and 10. Remember, I write the square root first, okay? And so this becomes what times what?
9 times 3.
Okay, now here's the thing. If this still has a square root of 10, can we simplify that anymore?
No.
What will this probably end up having if this will work out?
The same number.
10. So can we think, oh, what multiplies with 10 to get to 160?
16,
Jacob. Give me this drink. Okay. So, what times 10 will get us 160? So square root of 16 times square root of 10. And hey, is 16 a perfect square?
Yeah.
That worked out very well. So this becomes what times square root of 10? 4 times square root of 10. Now, are we able to add those?
Yes.
Because we have the same radicand. And we get what?
7
times square root of 10. Can we still multiply it?
I wrote the times on my paper.
And that would be our answer. So is this that much different than doing it with variables?
Not just more steps.
Not really, but sometimes we just have a few more steps like that. Okay, Grace.
So it's like on our last problem, if in the like square root box was like 16 or something, it's something different, then can we still add the 3 and 4 since they are vectors?
Great question, okay. So Grace was saying, hey, if this was 3 square root of 10 and this was 4 square root of 12, could we add them? No, because they have to have the same radicand. So just like we can't add these right now, we have to change
like
them.
Add the numbers in front, like the 3 and the 7. Mm-hmm. No.
Because if this is like, if this was 2a and 3b, could we add those? No, same story.
Okay.
Yep. So we'll look for like terms. In this case, instead of it being the same variable to the same power, we're looking for the same radicand. Okay, great question. Any questions on that besides what's been asked? Let's flip the page. No. Okay. Number 4.
Yay! Woo! Can we just be the first 5?
On our own. Oh, yeah. That's pretty neat.
Can you change the number on the board?
I can't change it right here because this is a picture, but I can change it. Okay. Square root of 80 and square root of 320, are those like terms? No, but can we try simplifying to get them there?
Yes.
Square root of 80. What times what? One of them has to be a perfect square.
I think 4 and 40 and 2.
Okay, 40 and 2 is 40 perfect square.
No, 4 and 20.
Okay, 4 and 20. Okay, we can try 4 and 20. What is the square root of 4?
2.
Square root of 20. Are there any perfect squares in that? We want to check out always.
No.
What goes into it?
Ah.
2 and 10, 4 and 5. Square root of 4 times the square root of 5. So if we kept going, does that mean we could have picked a bigger perfect square to start?
Yeah,
but is it okay that we didn't? Yeah, we can still get the same answer. So what is the square root of 4 again?
2.
So what's 2 times 2? 4 square root of 5. So anyway, let's think about this. If we ended up getting 4 outside, then what would have been our radical if we had gone bigger? Raise your hand if you can think about that, if you have a hunch. Grace? Not quite. Okay? So if we had square root of 4 turned into 2, square root of 4 turned into 2, what would it turn into the 4? What square root would it turn into 4? Square root of
16.
16. So we could add 16 times 5. Square root of 16 times square root of 5. Okay? So that's just kind of a way to think about that. Okay. So we have 4 square root of 5. So what's this one probably gonna end up with if this one's gonna work out?
5.
It has to end up with a square root of 5, doesn't it? So can we take 320 divided by 5 and then just see the perfect square? Okay, so take 320 off the side, divide by 5, and we say, okay, does 5 go into 3? No. Does 5 go into 32?
Yes.
6 times 30, end up with 20 left over, and 4. So hey, is 64 a perfect square?
Yeah,
so it ends up being square root of 64 times the square root of 5. So once again, once you do your first one, use that to see if you can help with your second one. It doesn't always work out, but if you're going to be able to combine them, it will. Okay? What is the square root of 64? So now can we combine these? I'm just going to keep writing it to make it to where we're at an even step now. So if you're wondering, Ms. Krause, why did you write the same thing three times? Because I wanted to make sure we got to the same step with the other one. Does that make sense? If you're wondering, even Stevens. Okay? So now what can we do with this 8 and this 4? Add them and make 12 times square root of 5. It's not 2, though. It's not a power, but it's times square root of 5. We're going to say 12 square root of 5. That's another way to write it. Like 3a means 3 times a. You can say 12 square root of 5 means 12 times square root of 5. Okay? I am actually going to have you do number 6 on your own. Okay?
And then the end.
Okay? I'm going to have you do number 6 on your own, the next one. Okay? I'm going to have you do the middle one on your own.
Whoa,
is that why is it? Let's just focus on this next one that we're doing right now. Okay?
Oh, it's a cross. Nice to meet
you. Hi, Mr. Crossland. Well,
now
you have to say hi, Grace.
Oh, hi, Grace. And Mr. Cross, nice to meet
you. And then
it's just back and forth. Oh, it's just back and forth. Okay.
You get it?
No. No, you're not. You wish. Your dad jokes aren't that funny.
Whoa.
The ultimate attack.
Yeah, it stays on
the
left.
The ultimate attack.
Simplify it the same way we've been.
Do you know who Mr. Wallace is?
Mm-hmm. I know David Wallace from The Office.
You're so funny.
Very good.
Doesn't
he
remind you
of
Mr. Wallace?
No.
Mr. Wallace is so cool.
Okay, we're going to go ahead and talk about this up here now for sake of time. 3 square root of 8. What goes in? What perfect square is a factor of 28? Square root of 4 times square root of 7, okay? And what is square root of 4? 2. Don't skip that step. Okay, what is 3 times 2? 6 times square root of 7. Now, what do we have? What do we might have a hint for what might be a factor of this one?
Seven.
It's probably going to be a 7, okay? Because that's what's left here. For these combined, it would have to be. So that's what I'm going to check for. Okay? So we say plus 2 times what times the square root of 7? 9. 9. And what is the square root of 9?
3.
Don't forget we have this 2 out in front. So what is 2 times 3? And what's 6 square root of 7 plus 6 square root of 7?
12 square root of 7.
12 square root of 7. Did the radicand change at all during that, during this last step? No. Okay. Questions on that? Okay, we will be done for today.
Good boy.